Okay, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel, but let's get right to it. The Hate U Give, for your consideration. I just watched this movie, and I really enjoyed this film. You know, there's something to be said by good storytelling without, you know, sometimes you need a break from all these blockbuster movies that are just saturated with CGI and special effects and get back to, like, really good storytelling. So The Hate U Give is based off of a book by the same name. This movie was rated PG-13. It made $32 million worldwide at the box office off a $23 million budget. So now, look, needs to make $46 million to break even. So it's probably hoping to get a boost or a re-release during the award season. But it's probably going to make all of its money on network television, streaming, DVD sales, that kind of stuff. Now, this movie, I'll read real quick about what it's about. So there's this character named Star Carter, and she's a young girl, and she's constantly switching between two worlds. That's in the description. She's poor and lives in a mostly black neighborhood, but also she goes to another neighborhood to go to school, and it's a mostly rich white neighborhood. So she has to balance the different lifestyles. And then, of course, Star's world gets shattered. She goes to a party, and then kind of there's a drive-by shooting that goes down. She hops in a car with a best friend who was a childhood friend that she grew up with, pretending to play Harry Potter with. And they had wands and did like that. Her and another one of her girlfriends, they were all, you know, 6 and 7 years old. One of the girls died from a drive-by shooting, and then when they were kids, so she's already haunted by that death. And the character then, as a teenager, goes to a party with her other best friend, and they run off in a car and get away because there's a fight that breaks out at the party. And then lo and behold, they get pulled by a police officer. And it's a play on what's been going on in society, where the kid doesn't really listen to the police commands, reaches back into the car to get a comb to brush his hair, and he gets gunned down and killed by the police officer, who is scared and thinks he's pulling a weapon. So she has to watch her best friend die. Her other best friend already died, and she goes into like a witness protection because she's going to testify at a grand jury. So she has to keep going to this white school where they're talking about what's going on and watching the news reports and everything, but not knowing she was the one in the car with him. And so she has to listen to all of the other perspective from the people that's going on. And anyway, it's all about this one little girl, Star. And she is played by Amandla Stenberg. And she did an amazing job. I really enjoyed her performance. I was so excited to see Russell Hornsby in this film. Right away, I was like, oh, Russell Hornsby! I loved him in Creed 2. I loved him in the TV series that's on Netflix called 7 Seconds. He's now my new favorite guy to watch on screen. Every time he puts a performance out, this guy gives it 150%, and you can see it on screen. I mean, I was just like, oh, Russell Hornsby. So I just get excited when I see this guy. So Common was in this film as well. He played a cop that kind of raised Star, because Russell Hornsby plays the character Star's father, who basically he's a former drug dealer gang member. And he served 3 years in prison, but never snitched. So when he got out of prison, the only thing he asked for from the gang was to let him go. And he gave him some money. The gang gave him some money to start a business, a convenience store, so he could try to do right by his family. And all he is about doing right by his family and treating them right and trying to raise them to be smart and aware of their surroundings and everything. And so, like, it's just a really good performance out of his character. KJ Apa plays the boyfriend in the white school, the prep school that Star goes to, the character Star, played by Amandla. And he did a really good job of trying to be compassionate and, you know, not seeing color. And even though all this drama is going on with the shooting death and all this other kind of stuff. And I thought he put on a really good performance. He's on a television show. I think my wife said when we were watching the movie, he's on Riverdale, which is like the Archie comics that they made into a TV show. I haven't watched it, so I don't know. Anthony Mackie is the gang leader, the local drug lord of, I think they're called the Four Kings. I think I could be wrong. Maybe I'm getting 7 seconds confused with this, but it doesn't matter. He's in charge of the gang, and he's the one that let Russell Hornsby's character go and then helped give him the money to start the business. And he's the only character in the entire film. Everybody put on amazing performances. He's the only character that, it's not that he didn't put on an amazing performance. Anthony Mackie did a good job. But after seeing him in the Marvel films and all that other kind of stuff, it's just, it's hard to see him play this character. I did a movie back in like 2008 called Bolden that Anthony Mackie was the lead actor in. And, you know, and a lot of my friends know Anthony. And so it's not that like he didn't do a good job. He did a great job. But it just didn't seem like this was his movie. But I could see how he wanted to be a part of this film and because it had such a great social message. It's a really good movie. The Hate That You Give, again, it's based on a novel. It's up for all the considerations for awards this season. So if you haven't seen it, check it out. It's still limited in the theaters, but like I said, I think it's going to get released during the award season again to make some extra money. All good performances across the board. The story was good. Everything was good. I really think you'll enjoy this movie. You'll also understand different perspectives and social issues. And so it could be an eye opener for someone who is not aware of what's going on in other neighborhoods and things like that. So anyway, that's it. So The Hate U Give, PG-13, I give it a thumbs up. There wasn't anything in it that was like, you know, like a horror film, scary. I mean, there's intense scenes and some violence when the cop kills the one young guy in the car. But other than that, it's a really good film. I think anyone over 13 should totally see this film and embrace it and enjoy it. Russell Hornsby, you go, man. You keep rocking it out and knocking out these roles because you're really good. And I can't wait to see what you do next. The Hate U Give, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, share this on social media, and we'll see you on the next video.